If you regularly notice swollen feet, there could be multiple possible reasons, and you are advised to seek medical help from your doctor. In this video though, we are going to discuss a very common and easily addressable cause of swollen feet. So let's begin this health sachet. If you notice swollen feet, don't ignore the signs and seek medical help. If the swelling is just on one foot, it could be because of an injury or a mosquito or an insect bite. However, if the swelling is on both feet, it could mean varicose veins, chronic lung diseases such as bronchitis or emphysema, congestive heart failure, kidney damage, liver damage, etc. None of these are to be addressed at home, and a visit to your doctor is important. Pregnancy has its own reasons for swollen feet. The uterus puts pressure on a vein called vena cava, which returns blood from your feet to your heart. This can cause the swelling. Another more serious possibility is a medical condition called preeclampsia. Once again, a doctor needs to be consulted. A trivial reason for swelling on feet and ankles could be because of prolonged standing. If you have to sit or stand in one place for a long time, such as in a stadium, standing in a queue, or using public transport for hours, you can get swelling in your feet. This is especially common in hot weather. Policemen and other service personnel who have to be on their feet for long hours usually face this problem. So do people who take long international flights and have to sit in their seat for a long time. Lying down with your feet elevated above your head level can reduce such swelling. Compression hosiery that give graduated compression on your legs can prevent accumulation of fluids in feet and ankles and can reduce this swelling problem. However, I have seen many people have swelling on their feet for a very simple and a common problem: protein deficiency. A protein called albumin is present in your blood. It has many tasks, such as detoxifying your body of free radicals. But its main function is maintaining something called osmotic pressure in your body fluids, especially your blood. This draws water into your blood and prevents it from accumulating in the surrounding tissue. When you're deficient in protein, your blood levels of albumin drop, the osmotic pressure drops, and fluid starts accumulating in body tissue, causing swelling. This is most noticeable in your feet and ankles, which are weight-bearing lower extremities. Incidentally, albumin also neutralizes toxins. It has a role in platelet functioning, which has to do with clotting mechanism. Albumin transports various substances across your body, such as bilirubin, fatty acids, hormones, certain minerals, and even a few medications that you take. So if you are short on albumin, as is the case in protein deficiency, you can expect some of your medicines to act weird. Normally some medicines are protein bound, so they are slowly released in your body over a period of time. And so their blood levels are sustained at a certain level for a long period of time. But in case of protein deficiency, they become unbound and freely circulate in your blood. This can raise their active levels to a very high level, and then as your liver metabolizes them, the levels can fall sharply. In a sense, instead of a sustained level of medication in your body, you end up getting a sharp spike followed by a sharp fall in the level of the medication. Now all that discussion is for another video. Just keep in mind that if you are deficient in protein, a lot of these issues will surface. Ideally, 20% of your calorie intake should be from proteins. However, 70 to 90% of the people, especially those in the developing countries, get merely 5% or so of their calories from proteins. And over the years, this can lead to significant protein deficiency. There are many other symptoms through which protein deficiency manifests itself. For example, hair fall, low immunity, tiredness, and muscle cramps. I have another video on my channel which discusses all such problems of protein deficiency. So if you see swelling on your feet, do contact your doctor. However, also make sure you are getting adequate amount of protein through food or through protein supplementation, or preferably both. I hope this information was useful to you. If you like it, please forward a link to this video to other people. Click on the like button below. You can click in the circle in the middle to subscribe to this channel. And to see more videos on similar subjects, click in the box on my left. Remember, ignorance is a very bad idea when it comes to staying healthy. Thank you.